Jace! Welcome back to Gods on the Line! March comes in like a lion. We're at episode 17, and this is a double feature. Some Gods on the Line will only have double features from now on. I'm pretty sure it's 22-22, right? So yeah, it works. Okay, I should have started like this from the beginning. Last time, what happened? Last time, we learned about the semifinals, right? It's the semifinals of the tournament. And Nikaido's brother, I think it's his brother, he calls him Onija, won. And then now, Rei decided to actually go to the workshop. Yeah. So they're learning together with this guy with a really, really scary glare. And Nikaido's there, and Nikaido's brother. Yep. It's good. Rei seems to be having a lot of fun. He first had fun at school with the science whatever club. They all had glasses, so, and one of them had a mustache. It was amazing. It's the kind of mustache that you would never find on a high school student. But yeah, okay. And then he was also having a lot of fun with everyone else there. Well, fun in quotations, but I think it's fun. Because it's basically the shogi players arguing about which strategy is best between two strategies. And then I honestly think it's fun, even though they say they are angry, they look angry. But talking about your passions and being passionate about it, and the passion turns into anger in quotations. Yeah, that's great. That's a great feeling. Okay, it's basically why I have this channel right now. I want to talk about anime. Okay, let's start this video. Okay, I've got it up right here. And there's going to be a 5-second countdown. It's going to count down from 5. Because that's what they do. And the 0, the sound of a beep. Yep, that's when you start up your own ninja. Because that's when mine starts as well. And that's the very first frame. Okay, timer goes here. Opening. Also, VLC breaks a lot whenever I'm watching Sangatsu no Lion. I don't know why. Also, the songs here are amazing. And I got someone tell me that the third one is great. Like, I don't know. I really like the first one so much. Oh, it's that guy. I know who that guy is now. The guy with the mustache. It's the chemistry whatever club. And the guy is just... he's the shortest dude here, and it's like, and it feels like he's towering among them. And this guy, I don't know what his deal is. Seems really cold, but he also seems like he's not a bad dude. Goto on the other hand. I want to see more of Kyoko as well. Mostly because she's really cute. Second, because I'm worried. I'm very concerned about what happened. What's happening? Okay, let's go. Silver thread. Okay. Silver lightning! Is this the finals?
See it?
Yeah, I know that feel. I still feel that way. I'm 22. The guy will switch.
You wouldn't feel that way.
What is he? Oh, he's a disciple. Okay. Oh. That's nice. Thought it through, but he's just fun to be around, but it's still mature. And he'll die, okay. Hell yeah. What it feels to be out to have a dream. Another thing of Rey not taking Shogi that seriously, even though he's facing behind. What's that? Can't blame you, dude. Yeah? Oh, it's your dad? Oh yeah, it is. Oh! It's the, okay. Okay. I don't think Ray's gonna do that though. The chairman. The chairman is fun, I love him. She's close. That's. We're bringing this up, okay. Running away from home. Where is she going? I mean, she went once. Whose fault do you think that is? I mean, sorry, Ray. That's kind of a shared. The most serious faces right now. What is he gonna tell him exactly? Is it about Koto or... My dog is barking. I don't know if you can hear it. Yay. Interesting looking at the boy passing his soldier. So yeah. doesn't seem to care at all. What's up with him? He isn't human? I don't think I should take that literally though. Maybe he isn't actually human. He kinda made it rain? Or coincidence, water surface. Whoa. Some presence right there. Okay. I have an idea what on that he's not human part. I'll talk about it later. I got chills. What the hell? They go to different places, that's cool. Yeah, 7 matches, that's a lot. Oh, it's Gil! I was just talking about her. She looks angry. Not really. It's kind of... Oh! How is this gonna work out? I don't get what's the dynamics gonna be. I stuttered a lot. Okay. Hina seemed scared as well. Hina and Momo. Oh, they can't bring the sushi! They were so excited about it! Strong will, sure, let's go with that. Good answer. God. That hurts. Why? Why exactly? Okay. Yes. Yes. Ah, Hina! I love you, Hina. Let's not go there. She's like 14. Ah. Hina! Yeah, I was about to say. Hina swore. That little is a lot. I know that, Akari. I love that. Are they gonna talk more? Oh, yeah. She's eating everything! I have something to talk about this here. I like okra. Ah, that's pretty good. I was at the point of hating her earlier. And now, it's like, yeah, she's too cute to be hated. I was wondering why Rei had a bra in his closet, and apparently it's Kyoko and getting undressed. Oh, he had to eat. You like? Yeah, very separate. I kinda hate that Kyoko is so cute. I knew it was going there, I was waiting for it, and I was not disappointed. Let Ray speak. Catch it! You're not really trustworthy. I think I kind of understand her. All of what I'm about to say about her is going to be speculation, just saying right now. Yep. Oh, he was a former disciple. What the actual balls? Not nice. So, there's something to talk about later. We're going back to that. Okay. You mean he's going to school? Yay! Nagaira's older? I think this is just gonna be fun. Pupils dilating, that's a good sign. And the music. That's just mean. They have the same rank. Say yes. Yes. That's nice. And that's a pretty lake river. Interesting. So much to talk about this episode! And no, even if this takes longer, I'm still gonna make this a double feature. Don't worry. I mean, you're not worrying about that. You already saw the title. So I need... Alright, there's three major points I want to talk about. Okay. But Kyoko, most importantly. There's a lot of things to talk about Kyoko. I'm trying to remember what the three major points are. I have this fucking notebook right here. Why am I not writing this shit down? I'll do it the very next episode of this. Okay? I need a pen. I have so many pens. I even have markers. What the hell? Why am I not writing shit down? Why? Let's use this one. Yeah. Actually, no, I like this one more. Okay, again. Okay. We're gonna talk about this episode after I put away these pens. Add sound effects to that, Jason and JC. I'm pretty sure I forgot about that because I don't really edit the reaction videos that much. Okay, let's talk about this episode. Let's go. Okay, chronologically. Oh, the first point is Soya. The first big point. The first small point is, well, we now know that he's not, Nikaido's really not the little brother, but he's a little brother disciple, so just treat him as a little brother because he's his disciple. And they talk about the fact that, and it's just like, it's played off like it's this not serious discussion about, yeah, it's when it's my turn to play the tile match, I should be getting used to this right now. But Nikaido's serious, which is the complete opposite of what Rei is. Rei basically lived through Shogi because he had to survive as the cuckoo bird, as he puts it, in the way earlier episode. And even though I'm positive, I'm 100% sure that this guy with the glasses and his long flowing black hair loves this sport, loves this board game. And I think he's just trying to... He's having a hard time accepting the fact that he actually enjoys this game. Simply because he's so amazing at it that he almost never has to think about it. Like in the last few episodes, we saw him become very arrogant to the point that he lost so easily to Nikaido's master? Yeah, I forgot his name. So, yeah, there's that. My peer was already... While I was running, so he was getting lost. Let me just get it. My peers already hardened his role, which I actually don't blame Rei for. Rei has been through so much. Okay, here's the thing. I believe that mental and physical health, and by whatever the fuck the other word is, by that, mental and physical disabilities hinder someone about the same amount, and it depends on those disorders. And Nikaido has a weak kidney, I believe. And then Rei has all these mental health issues, his trauma, his depression and stuff. So the thing is, even though I don't blame Rei for not hardening his resolve just yet, I also find it that Nikaido's on the same field, with the same shoes, with the same disabilities, not the same disabilities, about the same level of disabilities, which makes Nikaido far more amazing than Rei, in a sense, in that particular sense. Let's talk about Soya. Apparently, he started raining. Okay, I'm pretty sure that's just coincidence. So, here's the thing about... he isn't human. There we go. And later on said, someone said that that's the smile of the devil. And when he smiled, as they said that, I actually freaked out a bit. I got chills. This is a little theory. Hypothesis. Let's go with hypothesis. I think that Soya is Rei. If Rei is like an overpowered Rei, let's say that Rei did not feel any guilt from being the cuckoo bird in his house. Rei just went along and actually became better and better at shogi. Even though he knows that, he not really knows that, because it didn't happen. He feels that it would hurt his step siblings. So, let's say Rei didn't do that, and Rei just became this super amazing shogi. I think that would be a Soya. Because, even though Rei didn't become this ultra amazing high school shogi player, slowly, we've been 17 episodes, we're 17 episodes in, and Rei is only slowly getting happiness. And I believe that if he actually went to that other path, to becoming this ultimate shogi player, he would become a lot like Soya, who just doesn't give a shit about anything. Although I don't know that much about Soya, so I might be completely wrong. I must be completely wrong. Okay, that's a good point. Yeah. Let's go here. He could be compared to a god, however. Someone said... Oh, that's some cool visuals. And then he smiles. That little freaky smile. This devil has the same kind of face. Let's be real. Soya seems like with white hair, like this very, it's very, very proper elegance to him. It seems like he's this really good guy. Like, yeah. But I don't know who coded that the devil is actually disguised as the nicest person. I fireface that in the worst way possible. I have to beat that monster twice and get 2 voice stars. Alright, there's a big thing that's gonna happen in the 6th game because it's this guy's hometown. Pretty river! Look at a pretty water! And look at that pretty girl. Okay. Let's talk about this little scene where okay, first of all, yes. Kyoko would be the type of person who would easily think that Rei snitched on her. Simply because what happened? Their dad. What's the word? What? Stop! Put a stop on my character. Okay. How old is Kyoko? Probably not as old, not that far from Rei. 20? 19? I don't know. Because you also learned that Goto was a disciple of Rei's stepdad. So that means he can't be over. He should be around 40, 35? Maybe? No, it can't be 35 because that means that Kyoko is 15. So maybe 20. Let's go with 20. So 20 and 40, I believe. That's just, those are speculations, come on. And Momo scared us balls because, well, she's a kid. Hina scared, but also confused. And since she's not that young, she'll just be, what the fuck's going on here? Also, she swore earlier, she said pissed! Yeah, Hina! Okay, and of course, Akari does the proper thing, which is walk away, not run away. Who are they? And this is something that made me almost... I almost want to punch Kyoko immediately. It's a... your woe is me act again. Because that's basically what it is. It's the cuckoo bird in his step family. Where... I'm amazing at shogi, take me in. My parents and my little sister died. I'm amazing at shogi, take me in. And which led to Kyoko... stopping shogi because her dad told her so. And pretty much the same thing for the dude, the younger brother that has never been seen. Like, that's never been seen actually. Only silhouettes, I believe. And Okay. Also, the cherry blossoms, like, those are some great effects right there. Like, they didn't need to add that much detail. Like, they could add that to when they're introduced, but that's a lot of detail, which is great. Okay. You can look in our direction. Okay. Okay, here's the thing I want to talk about Kyoko. This is something I'm really interested in. Because look at her. She seems like a normal girl, normal. I gotta say, she's real cute. I like her a lot. Just saying. She's so cute. Even the way she acts. It's so cute. And the thing is, I'm gonna talk about something that I have some knowledge about, but not that much. So, I'm pretty sure I talked about this at some point. When there was an episode with Kyoko in it. Okay, let's go. Kyoko has something of a... What's the word? It's kind of PTSD. When a kidnappee falls in love with a kidnapper. What is it called? Stockholm Syndrome. That's not the right thing, but it's close to that. That's not the right disorder. But, Kyoko has this thing where, since her dad doesn't give a shit, but is being really mean to her, and is prioritizing his stepbrother, it gave her this sense of, I want to be free from them. And usually in these types of cases, I'm not sure why, but in these types of cases, especially for the girl, they usually end up in situations or in relationships where they're abused by their partner. And they are okay with that. That's where the Stockholm Syndrome comes in. And they're okay with that. Because for some reason, when you are mistreated really badly as a kid, the moment someone shows you some affection, you would also expect some sort of mistreatment. Because you're starving for that affection, but also your mind would start looking for, wait, is it normal not to be hurt? Kind of thing. I don't know if this is making a lot of sense or any sense. But I'm trying to say something here. Yeah. So, I believe that Kyoko is a really good-hearted person. Kind-hearted person, even. I believe she is mostly good. It's just that years, pretty much her entire life, has been fucked by his father. And then, not literally! Now, she can't understand her relationships, or which is normal for anyone who was mistreated as a kid. You can't understand how relationships work. It doesn't even have to be romantic, but romantic relationships are the worst, because it's more complicated. Which is why she can be nice to Rei at times, and be a total asshole at the same time. Well, not at the same time. At a completely different time. Minutes away. Oh, I think it's the last bit I want to talk about. Okay. The munchkin called me a witch. Or which I could just... this little Rei monologue, I'm not gonna go through the entire thing. Because there's so many great Rei monologues. Just saying. Rei is a... really depressed dude. But his monologues are really deep and... for some reason, not that edgy. Like, when you usually write a character that's depressed and you want to make this guy the main character, you want this guy to be the narrator, it usually ends up being an edgelord, but Rei isn't. It's really cool. The room was dyed blue and it felt like we were drowning, which is really interesting to me because Rei, what was I gonna say? It's really interesting because the very first opening, there we go. The very first opening was a metaphor based on drowning. The opening was Rei drowning in his sorrows and his depression, and the ED was him getting out of the water. And also a part of that is when he said that when he gets out of the water, he would just wants to stay in the solitary island where nothing happens. Which is tying back to this thing where they say that I don't think I've changed at all. When he meets up with Nikaido right here. We're in the same rank right now, but why haven't I grown myself? That's something Rei said. And that's basically what he was doing for most of his life. And he's still doing it, to be honest. The very first step he did to get out of that vicious cycle was actually to join this workshop. Which is a really good move for Rei. Good job, Rei. You did great. Because for people with depression, for people with any kind of mental illness that's affecting their personality, it's extremely difficult. It's one of, if not the most difficult thing to, to take the very first step. And once you're in that very first step, you usually give up almost immediately. It's sad, but that's just how it works. And before you say anything, I have been through a lot of this stuff. Yeah. We're gonna start the next episode in a bit. I need to sync everything up. I need to pee. I need to drink water. And I'm thinking of making coffee. You're back! I'm gonna keep this in. Hello! we're back! So, episode 18! Timer! Go! Somewhere around here. Oh, opening alert. Okay! It's 2017, right? This OP looks so pretty. And I like the song as well. It's very cute. And I don't know what the lyrics are about. It might be about skinning a human alive. Which is amazing because that adds a little mystery to it. Oh, it's cute. Yeah, they said goodbye, bystander. So, maybe they skinned the bystander alive. I don't know. I don't know what's gonna happen in this episode. I have no idea. I mean, the times when I had an idea, those ideas were, you know, wrong all the time. I need to move this a bit. Okay. Recording. Okay, let's go. Torrent. That's a good Pokemon ability. So you also work. How far though? Huh. Okay. No. The contrast in their faces. Flowers. Oh my god, that looks pretty. Wow, black flowers. Black cat team. Oh, it's a Star Wars reference. Sure. I'm not bothered reading it. My dog is barking. No, that's a Jedi. Who has that cape? Because that's obviously Darth Vader. Is that Obi-Wan? So we're providing metaphorical images. I don't think they had a fist fight though. I haven't watched that in so long. They're both wrong. Okay. Oh! That actually works for me. We're gonna start another war, aren't we? interesting. Yes! That's kind of the point of this workshop. Kimochi warui. That's something that happens in real life. What are you gonna do with that cactus anyway? Steam buns up in you. Ah! Nikaido, I don't think you would be in a physical fight. You're thinking about it. What could Ray mean by that? Gonna do. Okay. Okay. Oh, it's raining. Soya must be somewhere. Near. What? Are you trying to figure out what he said? Oh! Black coffee. Eh, it's good enough. Also, I'm blurring. Ah, focus. There we go. I still don't kind of get that. It's a very, how do you put it? Oh, actually interesting. I have to look up Yamanaka later. Seems his voice sounds desperate. You want to bring coverage to your place? The king? What? Okay. Whoa. Whoa, that's cool! Oh, interesting. I'm gonna get my thumbnail somewhere here. Ray's probably losing. From the looks of the visuals. Oh! Yeah, we're gonna get a flashback. Please give me a flashback. So, did that really happen? Oh, okay, it did happen. He was tired. So that's what, okay, the visualization was. Oh, progress. Yes. Oh, okay. So that's not what he wanted to ask. Oh. What? Is that it? Okay. It isn't. Oh, actually, Ray looks really handsome like that. I should be taking notes. I don't want to. Torrent. That's the torrent. Passing time. It is gonna be a cute little segment. Report card. Mouseland. Totally not Disneyland. He wants you to have fun. I mean, for an introvert, it really isn't that fun. An entire year already. Oh. Yes. Or that might be my thumbnail. Everything's so pretty in the show. Exactly. He actually makes meals now. Don't we all?
Mm-hmm.
True.
Man, this is hitting way too close to home for me. Chills. That hit way too close to home. Ah. He's crying? I feel you, Ray.
Oh, Ray, that's a better suggestion. Odin. But yeah, going to really loud places with many people. That's not for us, Ray. Mattis? Oh no. You won't reach the. Aww. Let's go! You can do this, Yamada. I can remember your name, I'm pretty sure. What's this? Akari and the rest. Yes, Nihina. There's no Akari, okay. How about last episode? It's pretty... Oh! They're so nervous! Milk. I mean, you ate some! That's like the only thing I ate! Aww. I've never tried wasabi before, is that weird? Milku! Gunyu! Are they gonna leave? Okay. Do you think it's Ray's girlfriend or something? I don't know. Okay. She's still asking that. Painful. That's That's a good way to put it. Especially in front of a kindergartner. Nice.
Hmm.
Nice. That's a very nice way to put it, right? What are you thinking, Harry? What? I don't get it! It's Spooky Sensei. The god is hangry. I thought we were gonna get a sequence of just that. I was kind of wanting that. Also, VOC bro. Okay, there we go. Oh, yeah! Aww, it's far away! I wanna hear the song. Of course, Akari knows. Oh, the epic verses. Actually, I kind of take that back. I have a theory that Ray likes Ryoko for some reason. Yeah. Okay. Did he lose? Huh? Whoa! Yeah, that's sad. Wait, that's it! 43 minutes! Where did it go? Let me open Google Chrome and look for Yamanaka. Just... Oh, Yamanaka is not a real place. What? Or am I... Is it... Huh. Maybe I remembered the name wrong? Maybe it's not a real place. Okay. I'll just go with the lair. Okay. There's less to talk about in this one. But quite a bit to unpack in the very first half. That little part with Inasawa Sensei, I believe, and Ray talking. The teacher's words. I don't know if I should say this. Okay, I can say this. I'll say it later in the discussion portion, which is about to happen. Okay, pause. Lower the volume. And let's go to the very beginning. Okay. Woo. Okay. Let's go. Fudge! Okay, let's talk about the very first half, which was about Vista. The workshop. Okay, so first of all, just wanna say kudos
to all this great animation.
And I think they explode differently as well. Like, boom, okay, okay. Yeah, and then the black ones explode like... Yeah, they explode quite differently. And we get a Star Wars reference. I like how... There are many words here, so we're providing metaphorical images as accompaniment. I like how they're not subtle about it, and the faces they make is really worth it. Especially Nikaido. Nikaido's art style, the way he's drawn, it's a tiny bit like away from the rest of the show. It's a tiny bit different from the rest of the show, which makes it perfect to make faces of. Because if someone makes faces in you, it's usually not. Let me repeat that. When someone like that makes faces, it's a lot more funny because they're already made to be somewhat of a funny character. And this guy, he's kind of alright, but he always has this scary face. So fudge. Press the wrong button. What the hell? Let me go here. 15. Okay, there we go. Okay. Did you think my screen went smaller? Oink. Okay. Did you think did you want to say something abstract and think we interpret? Because first of all, Kiriyama is a genius. If we define genius as someone who has innate intellectual abilities that far surpasses the average human, then yes, Kiriyama is a genius. Sure, he might not be better than, say, I forgot his name, Shimada-san, but Shimada had to learn a lot, and Rei had to, like, read a single book or something, and it's just, He still learned, he still studied, but it didn't take much effort at all for him to be like, so yes, he is a genius. And secondly, he's been studying by himself, so whenever he says something to himself like, this is disturbing, kimochurui, then he understands that because that's himself talking to himself immediately. And that's something about innately talented people. Is that they're terrible at explaining how to get to conclusions that they go to. Because they usually go to that immediately without even going through the solution. Okay. Also, Nikaido, if you're gonna fight this guy, I don't think you would win. just saying. I mean, you're pretty thick. Let's go with that. And that's some great body armor, but yeah, we might have some kidney failures. They're free tomorrow. Okay, let's see this. I want to see this. First, only 2 wins. Your hometown. There's nothing there, just snow, there's mountains, there's everything. Like, I wanna check what it's called. Yamagata, okay, let's look that up. Yamagata. Yamagata. Oh, it is a city in Japan. Oh, it's a prefecture. It's an entire prefecture, okay. Okay, mountain region. Some recognition, okay. Okay, okay, okay. Climbing? Really long winters, what the hell? Okay, and really hot and humid summers, but also long ass winters. spring and autumn are short, okay? Economy, there's most. The economy is made out of fruit. Okay, so it's a very rural area. Okay. I don't know what exactly he wants. That's why something. So he says. It's not a place for real or nice patties. That's exactly why. Okay, I'm just taking a guess here. I think I said this in the reaction itself. But, does he want there to be media in the Yamagata prefecture so that it would get more attention? Is that what you want? I don't know. I really don't know. I don't see the benefit in that. Huh. But the thing is, that place sounds actually really cool. Get it? Long winders? Cool. Never mind. Yeah, cool. So, next. Oh, let's go. Okay, there's something to talk about it. But first, look at that! Whoa! And it's just like a sea of red underneath, but it's blue water above. I don't know if that signifies anything. But now it turns all blue. Oh, and even their hair gets swept away properly. Whoa! That looks badass! But apparently it is a dream, but it's just like a visualization of what Ray felt. And we're gonna talk a lot about what Ray felt because that's really cool something that happened. They spent how many seconds in this? That's really cool. Okay, let's talk about the obvious first. Which is this guy is, they're both professionals. But this guy just has more experience, far more experience than Ray. Which is why these kinds of thoughts are like these waves of thoughts, these torrents. I get it where it's going right now. This torrent of thoughts is normal for him, yet Ray is being swept away by it. And I like this little thing where he says that he's tired. And I don't know if you saw that, but I went like that, because remember in the fight between Goto and Shimada? Goto was smiling normally when he's being interviewed even though he lost, and Shimada was depressed as balls and he was like very tired. He couldn't answer the interviewers properly. Ray realized himself, has he ever done this? And this is the very first time that Ray became tired from battling someone in Shogi, which means he actually took this seriously. Great. The show says that it's the muddy stream of thoughts that he couldn't handle, but you know that. It's mostly because of the fact that Ray, actually took this seriously. He's taking Shogi seriously now. Way more seriously than he used to. Just one more thing to talk about. Well, two. There's two more things to talk about. First, it's Mouseland, which is totally not Disneyland. Don't sue us. Just very carefully animated cherry blossoms in this entire scene. How long is this scene? It's like five minutes? Nothing? Okay. This is the thing that I was debating myself on whether or not I should say it. First of all, this is gonna be my thumbnail. First of all, mentally, not even mentally, anyone with disability, and it moved just some kind of really bad disorder that deters them from living a normal life. Always looks at other people. Because you can't not. So, every time you look at someone and they're progressing normally, you're like, man, I'm not doing anything. But the truth is, you're progressing far more than anyone else. The thing I was debating on whether or not I should say is the fact that this teacher right here, Mr. Hayashida, these are the exact same words that I wanted to hear when I was about Grace Age. I want to brag, okay? I'm not bragging when I say that. I went to school not studying at all. Almost not studying at all. And being an honor student. I basically learn anything almost immediately. As long as I put my mind to it, I can learn it in about a few days or a week. And I was also in a position like Gray where I'm very depressed at that point. And whenever I would look at someone that's say I had a classmate that what's a good example I can't think of any at the moment. Say I had a classmate who when I was say 17, so let's say I had a classmate who's finally had a part-time job. Actually, this happened even though when I was like 20. And then I'd be like, wow, I've never had a job. And feel relentlessly annoyed at myself that I can't do it because I just can't. I can't go normally to a workplace and then be, and then assume that I can do well the exact same thing over and over again in a bunch of people without at some point breaking down for no apparent reason. But the thing is, there's going to be days where I can't take baths or showers. I can't take showers for days, and I feel very bad about it. And then when I finally take a shower, I feel amazing about it. So what I'm trying to say is, that little thing where as good as you make your own meals, you take, you throw away the trash, you do those things. As for me, I take a shower after like 4 days. Four weeks. And then do the trash by it. That takes a lot more effort than being normal. Just saying. That takes a lot more effort than being normal. Because you were put in a situation that is already abnormal. So getting out of that situation is way more difficult. I went off on a tangent there. Moving on to the last point I want to talk about. Of course, Akari knows about her. Because, about Kyogo, because Akari is someone who saved Gray from after he got beat up by Goto, and Gray probably told the story. Yep. And then, of course, she's gonna be depressed about that. She says that they don't act like brother and sister, but when they were alone, it's like, yeah, they act normal. Normal. Huh. I just gotta say this. Either Kyogo is extremely shameless, which I doubt, or the fact, the simple fact that she could change her clothes in front of her brother is, I think, proof that she still thinks of him as her brother. This is something I did not expect as well. Kai Shimada actually conceded? Why?
Kai Shimada conceded.
So, he actually found... Okay, I think I got something. The reason he wanted to have a little game with Rei was to understand how... to have a plan, to have a strategy on how to fight Soya. And apparently, whatever they came up with didn't work. That's what he conceded. That's sad. Whatever the fuck. Shimada's goal is for getting to the place. Yamagata. There we go. To go to Yamagata. It's not gonna happen anymore. Also, we're at episode 18. There's like 4 episodes left in the season. I wonder what's gonna happen. Okay. Thank you guys for watching this video. If you liked it, why? Bye.